morning, everyone. This is Pastor Paul Graham, Senior Pastor of Restoration Praise Center, and I'm your host on Bible Boot Camp. And this morning, we want to invite you to this very, very opportunity of being able to make your bed. And when we talk about making your bed, we are talking about taking the opportunity to set the tone of your day. You see, whenever you have your room disheveled or just a little bit messy, and you make your bed, it still sets the tone of your bedroom. And sometimes your life may be seem a little bit disheveled, a little bit messed up, a little bit just not where you want it to be. But if you start your day with a devotion and you make your bed, meaning having a devotion and talk to God first, then at that very moment, you set the tone for your day. So we welcome you to our sixth day of Bible Boot Camp. Our sixth day of Bible Boot Camp, where we wake up 5 o'clock in the morning to start our day, to get ready for something exciting, to get ready for something new. So wake up and stretch your spiritual muscles and know that God is about to do something for each and every one of us that we probably haven't done for ourselves. So we want to wake up and stretch our spiritual muscles and get ready for a new day. I say welcome to each one of you and good morning. And just to be able to say good morning means you are alive and well. This very morning I have a special prayer for you. A special prayer for you that simply says to each one of us that we are blessed to get up this morning. We are blessed to be in the land of the living. And in that prayer it simply says, "Dear God, today I woke up, I'm healthy, I'm alive, and I'm blessed. I apologize for all my complaining. I'm truly grateful for what you have done in my life." And that prayer simply says, "Lord, we are grateful that we have this opportunity of waking up and being a part of the land of the living." So, are you about to make your bed? Let's make our bed today. Father, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done and for this very opportunity of worship and praise this morning. We give you our life. We give you our love. And this morning, let's let you know that we're grateful. So thank you again for this opportunity. In Jesus' name, amen. And so this morning, we want to thank God for giving us this opportunity of waking up this morning. I want to share a commercial with you. A commercial that asks the question, are you a fan or are you a follower? Are you a fan or are you a follower? Are you a fan of God or are you a follower of God? And by the time we're finished this, just listen to these words. We'll come to the understanding of what we should be, fans or followers.
The reason the church in America today is merely powerless is because its pews are filled with lukewarm, half-hearted Christians who don't know how to go farther. I've seen a lot of healings, I've seen a lot of miracles, I've seen a lot of the spirit, but at the same time, I've seen a lot of the flesh.
The word sin is not something that we talk about too much, not even in the church today. We have struggles, we have strongholds, but very rarely do we say, "I'm living a life of sin."
The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And the church is full of sin. The church is full of people that are living sinful lives, regardless of what Jesus did on the cross.
We don't know how to press on. We don't know how to keep going. We're okay with just enough.
But I'm afraid so many today are so deceived. They think they're just going to walk right in those pearly gates and say, "I was just having a good time."
See, Jesus knew the importance of going a little farther. He knew the importance of pressing on and not stopping where everybody else stops.
In the church, we are being taught empty promises.
We're okay with going to church every now and then. We're okay with just staying the same little wimpy Christian that we've always been. We're okay with that lack of anointing.
You and I, every day, we deal with heartache, and we deal with pain, and we deal with circumstances, and we deal with loss, and we deal with trials, and we deal with tribulations.
And I know that I know that I know my God is bigger than that. He said, "Mark, I need you. Peter, I need you. James, John, I need you. I need your voice." Just like he's saying to each and every one of you right now, "I need you."
But I got a question. What kind of relationship do you have with God? That one little thing, man, Pastor Darrell, I would have the relationship with God. of the 21st century. I would be the Moses of the 21st century if it wasn't for that one little thing. And that's why I'm preaching this today. Put the shoes on, won't you? Bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. I believe that you died for me so that I can live for you. It's heavy, it's hot, the battle's unbelievable. It's tearing at us, and it begins to drag us down. Do you know that God always has a plan?
And it started with selection, but as you study the Gospels, you find out that it didn't stay with selection. It then moved to servanthood.
Do you understand that you're going through what you're going through to get you closer to God? Do you understand that the God that you worship is all-powerful and nothing is impossible for my God?
We, as Christians, need to go a little farther. We need to go beyond the point that everybody else is going to.
And I got to ask you, are you listening to the instructions? And are you doing it His way? Or have you tried to put a whole new spin on it? Secular humanism. And if it feels good, go do it. Let me ask you this. Do you think God's going to set up an appointment with you when He's going to come? And do you think He's going to announce to you when He's going to leave? I tell you this morning, there's people dying and going to hell because they're doing it their way. Jesus! Thou Son of David, have mercy on me!
He has never made a promise that He will not keep.
Totally consecrated to God. Totally sold out. All in. God, I'm all in.
It is finished.
So don't go with me. Still, I will follow.
They're eating what He eats. They're talking like He talked. They're His servant.
Man, you're so close. You're so tight with God. It's being God. Why did they prevail? They believed God. Why did they prevail? They acted in faith. Why did they prevail? They did it God's way. You will hit your mark if you will trust in God.
Follower of God. That's what I want to be, a follower of God. What about you today? Are you a fan or you're a follower? A fan knows about God, but a follower knows God. Have you been listening to the instructions, listening to His word? Today, it is so important to know that God wants us to be followers, not fans. I want to share a special song with you, a special song that says, if we're going to be followers, then we've got to be faithful. And God has been faithful to us. And because He's been faithful to us, we want to be faithful to Him. You know, while this song is going, I'd like for you to just jot down in the chat room just something, anything at all, that you have been thankful for as God has been faithful to you. Today, I want to put God on a pedestal to say that He's been faithful to me, and that's why I want to be a follower of Him. So in light of that, I ask you the question today. Are you a fan or are you a follower? If you're a follower, then let's recount a couple of things that God has been faithful to us about. Like if I would write something, I would say that God has continually delivered me and taken away my sins. I love Him because of that. And in light of that, I would just jot something like that down just to testify to someone else. Maybe He did something for you, or maybe He constantly does something for you. So share that right now as you listen to this awesome song called I Call You Faithful.
So the song just simply says this.
It says,
I call You holy. Your name is holy. You are so holy to me. Somebody say,
I call You holy. Your name is holy. Holy You are, and the holy You
be. Come on, I want you to raise your voice all throughout this room. Let the world hear you here from the whole church.
Your name is holy.
Your name is holy.
Your name is holy.
Holy You are.
Holy You are.
For God. Hey, the question again is, did you make your bed today? Did you make your bed today? And I'm sure hoping that we have, one of us have this opportunity of making your bed. I'm looking at some of the answers today concerning, you know, how many people were thankful and what they were thankful for. And we know that you are thankful because you simply are telling us time after time again through this that you are thankful. And how thankful are you? Well, some people are just simply saying they're thankful for His grace and mercy and His unconditional love and for strengthening them and giving second chances. And God is just that kind of God that will do so much for us. He's that kind of God that will be willing to do so much. And so as we make our bed today, we start off with just simply saying we're grateful. We also have a faithful God. And we know this much, that God wants to do so much for us today. So what are our instructions as followers? We believe that God has a word for us today. And so while we look at this word for us and as we make our bed, we go to a specific chapter in the word, in Psalms 26. And we look at this chapter in Psalm 26, which ought to help us as we walk. So we want to talk a little bit about being examined by the Lord. Let's bow our heads together. Father, again, we come before you, first of all, thanking you for being an awesome God to us, a great God to us. And right now, Lord, as we just look at this chapter in Psalms, that your Holy Spirit will bless us in Jesus' name. Amen. So as we look at this verse in Psalm, I want us to just look and see what God is telling us. Psalm 26. Psalm 26 simply tells us, "Judge me, O Lord, for I have walked in mine integrity. I have trusted also in the Lord. Therefore, I shall not slide." I like that. I shall not slide. We are asking God to examine me, O Lord, and prove me. Try my reins and my heart. For thy loving kindness is before mine eyes, and I have walked in thy truth. I have not sat with vain persons, neither will I go with the dissemblers. I have hated the congregation of evildoers, and I will not sit with the wicked. Are you seeing so far that right now David is talking and saying to God, look what I have been doing. I've been holding on. I've been being that follower. As faithful as you are to me, I am being faithful to you. I know God knows it, but in his dialogue with God, he is simply telling God that I am doing the best that I can. And in verse 6, he says, I will wash my hands in innocency. So will I compass thine altar, O Lord, that I may publish with the voice of thanksgiving and tell of thy wondrous works. God is asking us to publish God's work, to talk about God's work, to let everyone know that our thanksgiving is in God. You know, time after time again, when God does something for us, it is so important for us to publish it, to tell others. But if you can't tell someone, at least live this word. It's the word of God tells us in verse 8, Lord, I've loved thy habitation of thy house, and the place where thine honor dwelleth. Gather not my souls with sinners, nor my life with bloody men, in whose hands is mischief, and their right hand is full of bribes. But as for me, listen everybody, this is it for today. But as for me, I will walk in mine integrity. Redeem me and be merciful to me. My foot standeth in an even place. In the congregations, I would bless the Lord. Today, our challenge is to walk in integrity. Today, our challenge is to have our feet standing in an even place. And what I love so much about this in this first verse, it says, judge me, O Lord, because I'm walking in integrity, and I've trusted in you, and I'm not about to slide. this is what I love, is to not walk among evildoers and not to sit in the place of the wicked, but to be an individual that walks and lives in integrity. My question to you today is, are you ready to walk in integrity? As you make your bed today, we promise God, we tell God from Psalms 26 that we are looking to walk in integrity. And this, I wanted to share with you the very opportunity to share this with someone else. And if you think about where you may be going wrong today or how you can go wrong today, think of this much, that God wants us to walk in integrity. Will you carry that around today? Would you carry that in your mind today? Would you take that with you today? That I want to be judged by God. And when He judges us, when He judges you today, when He looks at your life today, He will say that you have been walking in integrity. And right now, I want to take the time out to pray. I want to take the time out to pray for each one of us. And if you would like for us to pray for you, you can leave your prayer request at fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. That's fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. We know that so many of you have left on the chat room your Thanksgiving. And what we'd like to do is, while you write out your prayer request at this time, I'm going to play a little something as you write out your prayer request. And as you write out your prayer request, we want to take this moment to pray for you. Let's write out your prayer request at this time. Good morning again, everyone. I just want to just check and see. I've been getting some messages that we're off the air, but if you're on the air before this prayer, would you just type amen? Just want to see if we are on the air with some and not with others. If you are on the air right now, I'm just going to ask if you could just type amen, just to see if we're on the air or not. Will you do that just so that we can see where we are? Okay. Okay. All right, we're going to keep on moving, and some others are able to get on, some others are not able to get on, but we're going to get ready for our prayer. Let's bow our heads together as we look to God to continue to rest and abide with us and bless us today. Let's pray together. Father, again, we come before you, first of all, thanking you for the words that you've given us today. Thank you for life, and thank you for strength. and thank you for this very opportunity to pray and ask of the things we want and need in our lives. We recognize, Lord, that there are so many right now who is looking for prayers, looking for someone to bless them, and they only can be blessed by you. We have so many individuals right now who are reaching out to you right at this very moment. And so, Lord, we're asking in a special way that your Holy Spirit will be with us even now. There's one who's asking for strength and endurance, focus for favor today, Lord. And there's others that's asking for a special prayer for an individual named Jeanette who would walk this year, who suffered a stroke last year. We pray for Claudine at this very moment. Someone who is asking for added strength, who have lost their way. Lord, we know that you are able to do more that they can do for themselves. I ask you in a special way, Lord, that you will take Claudine's heart and move it from stone to flesh. Lord, I ask you that you'll bless her in a marked way. Be with Sean in a marked way as he's also been praying about a home. Be with Sarah as she's praying for her leaders, her church, the nation. Bless her in a marked way. Adam is asking for continued strength from you today. And Nina is saying that distress has been on her work for some time, but she's asking for faith from you, Lord. We're also asking in a special way that there'll be faith and the restoration for her husband. We're asking in a mighty way that your Holy Spirit will continue to rest and abide, because we need your Holy Spirit to take us day by day. Lord, we're asking in a mighty way that you'll forgive us of our sins this morning and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We're asking you to make us new this very morning. We're also asking that whatever is said and done will be pleasing to you. We want to please you today. And this morning, we're also asking that you will help us to not to be fans of you, Lord, to be followers of you. And so as we start our day, as we make our bed this morning, as we set the tone of our day through devotion, we say to you, thank you for being an awesome God. And bless us this very day, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. And so this morning, we want to thank you for joining us on our sixth day of Bible Boot Camp. That's right. We've got 24 more days to go. And we're asking that God's Holy Spirit would be with us. Because we know one thing for sure, that it may be rough to get up in the morning, but if it doesn't challenge you, then it won't change you. And so in this, we ask you to be strong. Tell your friends about it. Let's keep moving forward. God has blessed us with so many individuals that are on this morning. And we're asking that as God moves us forward, we will move forward with him in making our bed today. So the picture of the day, the pick of the day that we want. The pick of the day that tells us no matter what you've done, God is not shocked, surprised, or ready to give up on you. Somebody say amen for that. No matter what you've done, God is not shocked, surprised, or ready to give up on you. Share that with someone. Go to our page. Go to my page and share it with others, because God has not given up on you. And then tonight, if you'd like to join us at 7:15 tonight, we are in revival at Restoration Praise Center, where you can join us at 7:15 Eastern Standard Time to 8:30 as we preach on the book of Revelation. It's not a Daniel and Revelation seminar. We're just preaching on the book of Revelation, where we have insights to the closing of time. Again, we want to thank you for joining us. And we are asking each and every one of you to make your bed today, set the tone of your day, and let's be followers of Christ. Be blessed.